students, here we are with your solution for set 3 under this series of super 200 questions for your NDA upcoming examination. The solutions are as under, but before I start my job here, I want to convey you that those guys who are not connected with me in a direct mode can have these questions on our Facebook page for YouTube. And that contains each set containing 10 questions. From set 1 onwards, you may see each and every bit of question there. Try those. And for solution, very next day, you may see the so-called solution for these important 200 questions. So here it is, the very first question. Question number 21, first question of set 3. The question is demanding find the number of different matrices which can be formed using 12 different real numbers. We are having 12 real values which are used to create variety of matrices. I know if 12 values are there, they can be arranged in 1 by 12, 2 by 6, 3 by 4 or vice versa. Means there are 6 possible orders for such a matrix. And also I know whatever matrix I draw, suppose I am drawing a 4, 3 by 4 matrix, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So in all, I am having 12 elements, and these 12 elements on these 12 places can be arranged in 12 factorial ways. So answer to this is 6 ways are there to create 6 type of matrices in respect to the order, and 12 factorial for arranging those 12 elements in variety of ways. So final answer is this much. With 12 elements we can draw this number of matrices. Now coming to second question of this set, number 22, we are given a matrix, say A, 1, 1, 3, 5, 2, 6, minus 2, minus 1, minus 3. And 4 options are being provided to us, whether it is a nilpotent matrix, idempotent matrix, symmetric matrix, and none of these. Nilpotent, a matrix is said to be nilpotent if its n times itself involvement in multiplication provides you a zero matrix, nilpotent. Idempotent, if a matrix, if this matrix multiplied with itself to give the same matrix, it is idempotent matrix. And symmetric, if transpose of this provides the same matrix, then it is symmetric, otherwise none of these. So I am having 3 options. I am just running with first option. Might be it is nilpotent matrix. So what to do? I need to multiply this matrix with itself. Let A to be multiplied with A. A square. 1, 1, 3, 5, 2, 6, minus 2, minus 1, minus 3. 1, 1, 3, 5, 2, 6, minus 2, minus 1, minus 3. Just go for multiplication. You would find your answer. So, what we have seen here, one complete row has been converted into 0, 0, 0. Means zeros have been evolved. So it gives us a confidence that might be one more or two more times when this matrix is multiplied with itself gives us completely a null matrix. So we are just moving for one more multiplication of this outcome with my given matrix A. 0, 0, 0, 3, 3, 9, minus 1, minus 1, minus 3. With 1, 1, 3, 5, 2, 6, minus 2, minus 1, minus 3. इस मल्टीप्लिकेशन में देखते हैं, लेट डू द जॉब, दिस इनटू दिस, यानी कि ये फर्स्ट रो जिससे भी मल्टीप्लाई करेगी, ऑल एलिमेंट ऑफ फर्स्ट रो आर जीरो. नाउ कमिंग फॉर विद सेकंड रो, दिस इनटू दिस, थ्री वन जा थ्री, फाइव थ्री जा फिफ्टीन, नाइन टू जा एटीन, माइनस एटीन. So this way all these zero and finally all these zero. So I got a null matrix by multiplying A with itself three times. So A is a nilpotent matrix with index value 3. क्योंकि इसने तीन बार A का खुद से multiplication हुआ. उम्मीद है समझ में आया होगा. मूविंग टू नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 23. वी आर गिवन ए इज एन इनवोल्यूटरी मैट्रिक्स. ए इनवोल्यूटरी मैट्रिक्स है, मींस ए व्हेन मल्टीप्लाइड विद इटसेल्फ प्रोवाइड्स अस अ यूनिट मैट्रिक्स. और हमसे क्या कहा है, फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ आई माइनस ए इनटू I plus A matrix multiplication. Do as per distributive property I into I plus I into A minus A into I minus A into A. I into I into A into I A माइनस ए इंटू ए. वी आर गिवन इट इज आई, सो बेटर राइटिंग आई देयर. सो फाइनली व्हाट वी गॉट, दीज आर बीइंग कैंसल्ड आउट विद ईच अदर एंड वी जस्ट गॉट अ नल मैट्रिक्स. ऑप्शन नंबर ए हेयर. सो दिस इज द सो कॉल्ड सॉल्यूशन फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 ऑफ दिस सेट, अदरवाइज क्वेश्चन नंबर 23 in this super 200 question series. Now moving to question number 24. We are being asked find the value of A, some arbitrary constant, so that the volume of parallelepiped formed by the three adjacent pair of vectors representing the edges I plus AJ plus k. The second one is 0i plus 1j plus ak. And the third one is ai plus 0j plus 1k. We are given that the volume must be minimum and we need to find out the value a. वॉल्यूम कम से कम होना चाहिए. तो हमें मालूम है कि वॉल्यूम ऑफ दिस पैरेललोपाइप्ड इज द एसटीपी, स्केलर ट्रिपल प्रोडक्ट ऑफ दीज थ्री वेक्टर्स, एंड दैट कैन बी अचीव्ड बाय ए डॉट बी क्रॉस सी, और सिंपली गेटिंग दिस विद द हेल्प ऑफ डिटरमिनेंट ए वन ए वन जीरो वन ए ए जीरो one. Solving this we get, expanding against the so called first row, we get 1 into 1 into 1 minus 0 minus a into this into this 0 minus this into this a square plus 1 into this into this 0 minus a. So ultimately we got 1 plus a cube minus a. This is the so-called volume. And now we need to find out the minimum value. So getting minimum value, I need to just differentiate this v with respect to a. V dash, first order differentiation of v provides me 0 plus 3a square minus 1. To get point of extremum, I need to put this equals to 0, getting A as 1 by root 3. Getting A as 1 by root 3. Though there are two values, plus minus 1 by root 3. And I need to find out which one out of these two provides me the minimum value. Getting second order differentiation, I get 6A minus 0, and getting this value at A is equals to 1 by root 3, I get 6 by root 3, something positive. So this is point of minima, it is confirmed here, and this is demanded in the question, at what point of value of A the so-called volume becomes minimum. So answer is A is equals to 1 by root 3. Now moving to very next question, question number 25. We are being asked, find the direction cosines of the line. Find the direction cosines of the line 6x minus 2 is equals to 3y plus 1 is equals to 2z minus 2. It is not in standardized version, as x, y and z are not having their coefficient 1. So converting them, 6 times x minus 2 by 6 is equals to 3 times y plus 1 by 3 is equals to 2 times z minus 1. Just with denominator 1, carrying these coefficients in denominator, we get x minus 1 by 3 over 1 by 6, y plus 1 by 3 over 1 by 3, z minus 1 over 1 by 2. So I need to say the direction ratios are 1 by 6, 1 by 3, 1 by 2, or just multiplying each by 6 to simplify the same, I get 1, 3, 2, 6, 2, 3, 6. This is the set of DRs, getting its magnitude, 1 whole square plus 2 whole square plus 3 whole square, I get root 14. So DCs can be defined as 1 by root 14, 2 by root 14, 3 by root 14. This is the so-called answer to this question. Hope you got the same. Moving to next question number 20. Sorry, it was question number 26. 20, I just skipped 25th. So coming back to question number 25. Question number 25. I am being given constant forces, two forces. Force number 1, force number 2, with magnitude 6 unit and 25 unit. There was a correction in this question paper where 5 unit is mentioned, it should be 25 unit. Unit acting along the direction, acting along the direction, and those directions are I cap minus 2j cap minus 2k cap, and F2 3i cap plus 4j cap plus 0k cap. Since I get to know the unit vector in this direction, so dividing this by its magnitude, dividing this by its magnitude, getting 5 here as magnitude, 2 to the 4, 1 1 ja 1, getting 3 here. So I get the two unit vectors. So the net force acting here is this F1 plus F2, or I may say 6 times I minus 2j minus 2k over 3 plus 25 times 3i plus 4j cap plus 0k cap whole over 5. Cancel out whatever you can. Finally, 2i cap plus 15, 17i cap. Minus 4 plus 20, 16j cap. Minus 4k cap. I just got this final vector here in these terms. 17i cap plus 16j cap minus 4k cap. Along with I am given that the particle is moving from point A, 1 minus 2 minus 5, to point B, 1, 3, 4. So getting displacement by having vector AB, showing this displacement, x2 minus x1, 0 I cap, y2 minus y1, 5 j cap, z2 minus z1, 9 k cap. And thereafter, getting work done. Work done, F dot S. Dot product of force with displacement. This is the so-called force vector. This is the so-called displacement vector. Just getting their dot product, 17, 0, 0, 16, 5, 80, 4, 9, 36. So finally, answer is 44 units. Option number C. Now, just coming to question number 27. Question number 27. I am being asked, find the line. We are given the line shown here is parallel to which plane? And the line shown here in the question is x minus 2 over 3, y minus 3 over 4, z minus 4 over 5. And we are given four planes. And the line is connected to the plane by saying line is parallel to plane. If line is parallel to plane, the normal to plane is perpendicular to line. So dr of line and plane will give their dot product 0. And plane in first option is given to me 3x plus 4y minus 5z is equals to 7. So dr of normal is 3, 4 and minus 5. And dr of the line given to me are 3, 4, 5. Just getting their dot product. So this dot product is 3 into 3, 9. 4 into 4, 16. 5 into minus 5, minus 25. So coming 0. So the first option, the plane given in first option is the correct answer to this question. That means this plane is parallel to the so-called line. Coming to question number 28. From probability, we are given a person A speaks truth 4 times out of 5 cases. So probability of A speaks truth is 4 by 5. So probability A tells a lie simply 1 by 5. He declares some event that a dice is thrown and the result is 1 by 6. So let option C is result is 6. So probability of C as per this event say A, this event say B. Probability of C under option A, probability of C under condition B. When he is speaking truth, probability of getting a 6 in real manner in real condition is 1 by 6. And when he is telling a lie and saying that it is 6, it simply means the 6 is not there. And the result is 5 out of 6. Now, getting total probability, getting the probability of C, whether he is speaking truth or telling a lie, is probability of A into probability of C by A plus probability of B into probability of C by B. And what condition he is putting? He is saying that it is really a 6, find its probability. Means, out of this total probability, the share when he is speaking truth, yani ki he is honest on his side, probability of A into probability of C by A. And this is defined as probability of A by C. यानि कि उस सारे हालातों में से वो हालात, वो condition जिसमें कि वाकई वो सच बोल रहा है और result यही है. Just putting their values into the job, 4 out of 5 into 1 by 6, 4 out of 5 into 1 by 6 plus 1 out of 5 into 5 by 6. Just cancelling the denominators, I get 4 over 4 plus 5. Answer when it is really a 6 is 4 by 9, shown as option A in your question. Umeed hai you are enjoying these questions. Just going through all these topics from which these questions are being composed to just grow your knowledge as well as to check your knowledge, what you have learned at the time of execution, whether it is recalled or not. Very next question, question number 29 this time. How many words can be made out from the letters of the word independence? Independence. Independence, in which vowels always come together. Vowels means I, E, 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 E. These vowels must come together. And for rest, consonants, there is no obligation. N, D, P, again N, again D, again N, then C, then E. So taking this composed matter, which is under obligation, one article, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. In all, 9 articles are there. And they can be arranged in 9 factorial ways. But since 3 n's are there, so dividing by 3 factorial. 2 d's are there, dividing by 2 factorial. And these vowels under obligation in those 5 places on a continuous mode can be arranged in 5 factorial ways. But 4 e's are there, so dividing by 4 factorial, whatever value you get at the end, the answer would be 16800. Do this calculation on your own. You will find your answer certainly 16800. The last question of this set, now there in front of you. Find the number of divisors of 9600, including 1 and 9600. We are given a number 9600. And we are being asked, find the total number of divisors of it. So what you need to do? You need to just prime factorize this number. 9600. Talking of 96, 2 to the 4, 2 to the 8, 2 to the 16, 2 to the 32. Yani ki 2 raised to the power 5, 32, 3 ja 96, and thereafter followed by 100 more. 100 is composed of 10, 10 ja 100. Each 10 is composed of 2, 5 ja. So 2 into 2, 5 into 5. So finally, I am having my number 2 raised to a 7. 3 raised to 1, 5 raised to 2. And in case the job is to find the number of divisors, just pick the number of times each prime factor is involved here. Just get one more then each power 7 plus 1 1 plus 1 2 plus 1, and multiplied all three values 8 into 2 into 3. So there are 48 divisors in all, which can divide 9600 completely. How I got this? For that, just visit my channel tomorrow. On topic number system for all kind of competitive exams, for SSC, for the CDS, etc. यहाँ पर इसको आपको सॉल्यूशन मिलेगा. अदरवाइज अगर सवाल सिर्फ इतना ही था कि कुल डिवाइजर्स कितने, कुल कितनी संख्याएं जो इसको पूरा पूरा डिवाइड कर सकती हैं, तो वो 48 ऐसे नंबर्स हैं. आपको अगर हमारा काम पसंद आए या कोई शिकायत हो, कमेंट बॉक्स में जाकर अपने विचार रखें और मेहनत करते रहें. रेगुलरिटी विल लेट यू विन दिस कॉम्पिटिशन. थैंक यू.